There was nothing but controversy for the federal government this week over the asylum seeker issue. The United Nations condemned the government over its mandatory detention policy, as did the Australian Human Rights Commission. The commission said that indefinite detention was causing detainees serious mental health problems. Tonight, a moving story about an Iraqi man, Ahmad Al Akabi, who didn't survive his time in detention in Sydney. He's one of five detainees who've committed suicide in the last 8 months. Al Akabi will be the subject of a coroner's inquest later this year. Dateline's Fuad Hardy has been investigating his life and death.
In the holy city of Karbala, this is the last resting place of Ahmad Al Akabi. His widow and her sister have come to mourn him. I want to find the truth behind this pain. Why a man would leave this woman's love and the three young children behind? Why he took his own life? My search begins 13,000 kilometers from the Blake Cemetery. Here at the Villawood Detention Center in Sydney, the scene of recent protests by asylum seekers. Al Akabi committed suicide here last November. Twice he had been rejected as a refugee. Here are his friends from Karbala, also boat people. They were accepted as refugees. Now they live in Melbourne. Sayed Musab left Villawood 13 days before Al Akabi.
يعني هو أجلد واحد بينا يعني قلبه جلد وأنا أخاف يعني هو إنسان طبيعي أصلاً ينكت ماكو يجي ينكت علينا ماكو بالزورق من عبرنا عبرنا من ماليزيا لندن وسيب الزورق يضحك علينا
قريبا إن شاء الله.
The man called the detention center, another Iraqi who came on the same boat, is still there. He rushed to the bathroom where Al Akabi committed suicide.
This is Al Akabi's notebook. He wants to stay in Australia. He wants to learn English. That is really very sad.
I fly to Iraq. I want to meet Al Akabi's wife and family. The new Iraq is supposed to be democratic and safer than before. But many people still live in fear. I drive south to Karbala. Shia fight for control of the city. Al Akabi said he was persecuted here. This is his wife, Huda Muhammad Salah, and the three children.
هو داز لي صورة عن طريق الإيميل صورة ماخذها بالكام وكاتب عليها أحبكم وعيني متغير كبران 20 سنة يعني صدق فعلا متغير هواية هواية متغير يعني ما تتوقع هيجي شيء تتوقع إنه حياة أفضل راح يرتاح راح يعوض يعني الحرمان الشافه راح يعني حتى شكله
قلت احتمال الأكابي told the Australian immigration authorities that in Baghdad he had received death threats from Sunni fundamentalists. The family were told to
move or they would be killed.
After fleeing to Karbala, he was
pressured to join the Supreme Islamic Iraq Council. They demanded that he transport their people to a protest in Samarra, but he refused.
He claimed he was abducted by the Badr Brigade, a Shia militia, and tortured for 2 days.
The claimant showed some cigarette burns to his upper arm and some marks on his wrist from handcuffs, which, he claimed, were part of his torture.
Well, clearly the case officer believed him. There was no credibility issue there. Never questioned the fact that he had been kidnapped and held for ransom.
Marian Lay is a migration agent with many Iraqi clients. She was awarded the Order of Australia for service to refugees. Dateline has obtained the Al Akabi immigration decision and showed it to her.
Didn't question the fact that he'd gone from one place to another and fled, you know, from Baghdad to Kavala. So there was no issue regarding the credibility of who he was or what had happened to him.
Al Akabi's family paid the militia a ransom of $10,000. They released him, saying they would kill him unless he demonstrated he was a good Muslim. Fearing for his life after being released, Al Akabi met this friend here at this cafe and asked to hide at his small farm. He agreed, but said Al Akabi's situation was so dangerous. He didn't want him to stay at the farmhouse.
أحد المرات يجي علي أحمد فيجي يتخبيته هنا بهذا المكان لأن ما أقدر أخليه بالبيت. فإذا أصور هذا المكان هذا بصف هذا التنور.
وين تقدر تمشي
الحطب؟ تمشي عليه؟ هذا. هذا المكان هنا، هذا الحطب رفعته وخليته هنا لليل. لأن كان مطارد هو هنا خليته بهذا المكان بقى يوم كامل هنا أجيب له الأكل بالليل وأرجع.
But the immigration case officer found Al Akabi's claim that he had to flee after being abducted not to be credible.
Although the claimant did not agree with me, I believe that his release by the Badr Brigade after payment of $10,000 was actually the end of their interest in the claimant.
He says, yes, but it's the end of the matter because they let you go, because the ransom had been paid. Now, that's clearly ridiculous. I've had families from Iraq who I've dealt with where one after another member of the family has been abducted, tortured, and released on ransom payments, but the family itself is never safe. And if they do release that person and he doesn't behave or they want to go after him again, they will. The paying of the ransom was part of it, but you've also got to be a good Muslim. So it clearly wasn't the end of the matter. And I would have, if I'd been in his position, I'd have been terrified.
The case officer also found that Al Akabi
was more a victim of a criminal act of extortion and not targeted seriously for reason of his political opinion.
I think that's pathetic. clearly, you know, this is a political nexus, and one of the convention claims is that you are fear persecution on the basis of your politics, your political opinion. And here's someone who, you know, is asked to join the Supreme Council, and he refuses, and then he's picked up by the Barda Brigade, who's part of that, and taken away and, as I say, tortured. Now, if that's not for a political reason, what is it?
Al Akabi's case officer also studied US and UN reports showing a drop in violence in Iraq.
I do not accept as credible that he faces a real chance of serious harm should he return to Karbala or Babel or Baghdad at this time.
يعني أحمد لاجئ حقيقي.
لاجئ حقيقي نعم.
أحمد غير كاذب.
لا 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 لا. أحمد صادق. أحمد إنسان مؤمن وصادق جدا. لهالسبب هو خرج راح لأستراليا.
In April this year, even the Department of Foreign Affairs was warning.
We strongly advise you not to travel to Iraq because of the extremely dangerous security situation. Both foreign and Iraqi nationals continue to be at risk of being kidnapped or murdered.
Al Akabi appealed the decision to reject his refugee claim, but the decision was upheld. He gave up trying to stay in Australia and agreed to leave. But the man, the authorities said, was not at risk in Iraq, was too afraid to return to his homeland.
فكان مفكر انه يروح السوريا ويستقر هناك هذا اخر حل كان يفكر به وانه يسحبنا وراه احنا نروح اللي هناك ونعيش وياه هذا كان تفكيره يعني اخر حل اخر شيء فكر به
نعم ما يقدر يرجع العراق
ما يقدر
As Al Akabi waited and waited in Villa Wood, his fellow boat people from Karbala were released. He became frustrated and depressed. Life in Villa Wood was grim.
وضعنا يعني بدا نفسي يدهور قام يعطونا حبوب من هاي مع المنوم نعم. مو بس هو الكم كله يروح يستلم شلون ساعة بالأربعة أربعة إلا ربع نروح قبل لا يزعون العشاء نروح نستلم حباية ونجي هذا الكم كله ساعات شي يروح يستلم ويجي يعني دول الوضعية معه التعبان يعني الوضع النفسي هذا
مرة من المرات يعني لا يخابرني إنه كان يأخذ يتعاطى حبوب
نعم
حبوب يعني تهدئ مرة قال لي أنا الدكتور كتب لي 35 حباية
نعم
وقال لي مطيبة راح أخذهن جرعة كاملة قلت له تعاقل فقال لي راح أبلعهم قلت له لا تبلعهم قمت أحكي عليه لأن أدري بهم راح يأثرون علي لأن ماكو إنسان يبلع 35 حباية لما يأثرون عليه حتى وشو ما كانت النسبة فقال لي لا دكتور يفتهم وهو ذكر لي ياهن ها هي راح أبلعهم فعلا هو بدع الحب بس ورا فتره يعني واسبوع هو صارت الوفاه يعني انا اقول جزء هذا الحب هم له تاثير انه اثر عليه على صحته احتمال نوع من الموت البطيء
These and other medical issues may well be dealt with at a coroner inquiry due later this year. International Health and Medical Services at Villa Wood told Dateline they have full confidence in the training of our staff to assess and respond to detainees at risk.
Well, there are two issues here. Obviously, the issue of him.
Dateline has applied for Al Akabi's medical records under the Freedom of Information Act, but it may be a long wait. Even the chair of the government's expert advisory panel says she's been kept in the dark.
It's deeply concerning that the system may be dysfunctional, not providing the levels of care that our committee are recommending, and it's actually very difficult to get information that will allow us to better advise government on the sorts of measures that should be taken. We are the expert advisory panel, we're independents, we represent the various professional bodies. It would seem clear to me that we should be provided with the sorts of level of information and data that we need.
Also in Darwin,
Immigration Minister Chris Bowen's spokeswoman told Dateline.
The department is aware of Professor Newman's concerns regarding access to data and is working with her to address these concerns.
But we provided Professor Newman with new information. This photo obtained by Dateline allegedly shows where Al Akabi died in Villa Wood.
But that is almost purpose-built for the purposes of death. That's a very clear hanging point. That would be obvious to anyone who might have the wish to hang themselves. It's quite strong, which is obviously one factor that might lead someone to hang themselves from a point like that. So from a basic safety point of view, this is a very unsafe environment. Our committee has recommended very urgent safety audits be undertaken in the detention facilities.
The Immigration Minister's spokeswoman told Dateline,
much of the existing Villa Wood Detention Centre infrastructure is expected to be modified or replaced as part of the Villa Wood Detention Centre redevelopment, announced in the 2008-09 budget.
وين عيونهم مفتحية يعني هاي أمانة برقبتهم ليش المسؤولين عن هجرهم ليش يفتحون هيك شيء لما إنهم مو قد المسؤولية
شو الطالبين
إنه تفتحون تحقيق بهذا الشيء وطالبون بحقه إنه هو
In the end, Al Akabi did return home.
بصدق صدمة كلش قوية إنه أنت شخص تفكر إنه راح تكلمه ويجيك وين ما هو يجيبه لك إياه بجنازة
بناته ده تسأل عليا لحد الآن؟
يسألوني دائما يقولوا لماما إذا كبرنا ماما راح يرجع يعني ست صور شو تشوف الطفل من يجي لك يجي تقولي ماما إذا كبرنا بابا يرجع لنا يعني يعتبروا إذا مات يجوز من يكبرون يرجع لهم شو تشوف أماني بالعالم؟ كل أماني كل شيء أقدر أعوضكم بس كلمة ماما ما أقدر أعوضكم
Fuad Hardy reporting there, with production by Dateline's Jeff Parrish and Melanie Morrison. And if you need information or support in dealing with depression or other mental health issues, go to our website for a list of helpline contacts. That's at sbs.com.au/dateline.